Welcome to example program. In this video we will see how we can write a Java program to display the Fibonacci series. In mathematics, the Fibonacci series, denoted like this, is a sequence called as Fibonacci sequence, where the first two numbers are 0 and 1, and after that each number is the sum of previous two numbers. For example, if we have fn, then it will be n minus 1 plus fn minus 2. As we said before, the first number is 0, second number is 1, and after that every number in this series is the sum of previous two numbers. So it will be 0 plus 1, which will be 1, and then 1 plus 1, which will be 2, then 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 5, 13, and like that. Now let us see how we can write the Java program to display this series. Here I have already written some code. I have created the package called as fib, and then I have imported the scanner class from the util package so that we can take the input from the user. And then I have created this class fib, and inside this class we have the static void main method. Now here I have already declared a variable called as number, and after that I have created an object of the scanner class, and this is for taking the user input. And after that we are asking the user to enter the number of terms, or how many numbers we have to display in the Fibonacci series. And the user is going to enter the number, and we are reading that here. And after reading the user input, we are closing the scanner. So now here what we're going to do is we're going to declare the other variables that we need in the Fibonacci series. We know that a number is the sum of previous two numbers. So to store the previous two numbers, we need a couple of variables. Or to store the previous two terms, we need a couple of variables. I'm going to call them as t1 and t2. And we need another variable for calculating the next number. So I'm going to call it as next term. Okay. Now, in the Fibonacci series, we know that the first two numbers are 0 and 1. So we will initialize the t1 and t2 with 0 and 1. Now after that, we are asking the user to enter the number of terms that we have to print, and we are taking that number from the user. Now what we have to do is we have to display the Fibonacci series. So here what we're gonna do is we're gonna use a for loop, and let's create a loop counter variable in here. I'm gonna call it as counter. I will initialize this with a value of 1, and how long we want to run this for loop, that will be, we want to run this for loop a number times, that means the whatever the number the user is gonna enter, that many times we want to run this for loop. So here the condition will be counter containing a value less than or equal to number. And after that, we will be incrementing the value of the counter variable for each iteration. Now here, inside this for loop, what we do is we will start printing the Fibonacci series. Now we know that the first number that we have to print is 0. So 0 is present in this t1 variable in here. So we will print that to the screen. I'm gonna use the system.out.printf method. And here I'm gonna format the output string as %d and a space. And after that, here we need to provide the value for the placeholder, and that will be present in the t1 variable. That is the first term that we want to display. Now after printing the first term, we will write this program in such a way that for every iteration, the t1 variable will contain the next Fibonacci number to print. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna calculate the next term. So next term, or the next number of the Fibonacci series, is equal to previous two numbers, and they are present in t1 plus t2. Okay, now we know what is the next term after t1 and t2. So here we have the t1 variable initialized to 0, t2 initialized to 1. So we know the first two terms, they are 0 and 1. And the next term after the first two of them is the addition of the first two terms. So it will be t1 plus t2 will contain the next term, that is the third term. Now here With this printf statement, we are displaying the first term. And as I said before, we will construct this program in such a way that every time, for every iteration of this for loop, this t1 will contain the next term or the next number of the Fibonacci series to print. So the next number of the Fibonacci series that we have to print here is now present in this t2 variable. So what we do is we will write t1 equal to t2. So t2 was containing the next number to print, and now the t1 variable will contain that. So when this for loop goes for the next iteration, it will print the t1 variable's value, which will be the next number of the series. Once we have the t2 variable's value in the t1, what we can do is we can store the next term that we have calculated in t2. So we will perform t2 equal to next term, so that this program, this code will run in such a way that for every iteration, it will display a Fibonacci term or the Fibonacci number. Now, if it is confusing, don't worry. After running this program, I'm going to explain how this program will work. Now, I'm going to save this program and I'm going to run it. Enter the number of terms. I'm going to enter 5 and it will display 0, 1, 1, 2, 3. So it has displayed 5 terms or 5 numbers of the Fibonacci series. Now, if you look at this, then the first two numbers of the series are 0 and 1. And after that, every number is the addition or the sum of previous two numbers. So now let us see how this program is going to work. Now here, let us assume that the user is going to enter the number 5. User wants to display 5 numbers of the Fibonacci series or the 5 terms he wants to display. So the number variable will get the value 5. And then we have this for loop where we are initializing the counter variable with a value of 1. So the counter variable is initialized with a value of 1 here. Now after that, we have the variables t1, t2 and next term. In this for loop, the counter variable will be initialized with a value of 1, and then this condition will be checked whether counter variable is containing a value less than or equal to number. Number is containing 5, which is true. 1 is less than or equal to 5 is true. So we come inside this for loop and we will execute the statements which are inside this for loop body. So we will display the value stored in this t1 variable. In the output screen, we get the value stored in the t1 variable, which is 0. We have initialized t1 with 0, t2 with 1. So we get 0 in the output screen. And after that, we are calculating the next term by performing t1 plus t2. T1 containing 0, t2 containing 1, so the next term will be 1. And after that, we are changing the value of the t1 and t2. So t1 will get t2 variable's value, which is 1, t2 is containing 1, and t2 will get the next term value, which is 1. And after that, the counter variable's value will be incremented and it will become 2. Now, again, this condition will be checked whether 2 is less than or equal to 5, which is true. And that's why we execute the body of this for loop. So we are displaying the value present in the t1 variable. Now t1 is containing 1, so it will be displayed to the screen. Now after that, we calculate the next term, which is equal to t1 plus t2. So t1 plus t2 is equal to 2. So the next term will get 2. And after that, t1 will get t2 variable's value. So t1 will get t2 variable's value, which will be 1. And after that, the t2 variable will get next term value, so which will be 2. Okay. Now, after that, the counter variable's value will be incremented by 1, so it will become 3. And again, 3 is less than or equal to 5, which is true. So we execute the body of this for loop. It will display the value of the t1 variable, which is 1. And after that, next term is calculated, which will be t1 plus t2, 1 plus 2, which is 3. And after that, t1 will get t2 variable's value, t2 will get next term value. So t1 will get 2, t2 will get 3. So after that, the counter variable's value will be incremented again. So now it will become 4. Again, this condition will be checked, the for loop condition. That is 4 less than or equal to 5, true. So again, we execute the body of this for loop. We will display the value present in the t1 variable. T1 is containing 2. We will display that to the screen. And after that, our next term is calculated, which will be t1 plus t2. So 3 plus 2, which is equal to 5. And t1 will get t2 variable's value, which will be 3, and t2 will get next term value, which is 5. Okay, and after that the counter variable's value will be incremented and it will become 5. Again, the condition will satisfy, 5 is less than or equal to 5, which is true. So we execute the body of this for loop. We will display the value of this t1 variable, so which is 3 at the moment. And after that, next term is calculated, which will be 5 plus 3, which is equal to 8. And after that, t1 will get t2 variable's value, which is 5. And t2 will get next term value, which is 8. Okay, now the counter variable's value will be incremented again. Now it will become 6. Now this condition will fail, because 6 is not less than or equal to 5. So we come out of this for loop. And when we come out of this for loop, we have the output as 0, 1, 1, 2, 3 in the screen. So this is how this program will work. So this is it guys for this video. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you want to say something, then write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, do subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.